turn to our reporters at Dawn Services across the country now. Isabella Staszkowski is at the Shrine of Remembrance in Melbourne. Isa, good morning.
Sarah Carl, good morning to you. The dawn service here at the Shrine of Remembrance in Melbourne will begin shortly. This is the largest service here in Victoria, but we know, of course, there are countless other gatherings right across the state, in the city, in the suburbs, in the country, and along the coast. We're expecting thousands of people, for example, to meet in Torquay. Here in Melbourne last year, 40,000 people came before first light to pay their respects to servicemen and women past and present at the Shrine of Remembrance. This morning, of course, we've already seen plenty of people walking along St Kilda Road with their families. It is a fresh morning here in Melbourne, but it is quite lovely, so perhaps we'll have some very strong numbers yet again. This, of course, before the march along St Kilda Road, and we know that families will be lining the street there just to get a glimpse of all the action they'll be unfolding there, again paying their respects and honour to their family members, to servicemen and servicewomen. Of course, last night was the Anzac Eve game against Richmond and Melbourne. Richmond not coming out on top there, and it comes ahead of another big day of sport here in Melbourne. We know Collingwood and Essendon will meet at the MCG. The service here, as I say, is going to begin quite shortly. It will go for about an hour before that march around 9 a.m. Carl and Sarah.
Isa, thank you. Andrea Crothers is at Anzac Square in Brisbane. Andrea, good morning to you.
Good morning, Carl and Sarah. There's something just so stirring about the sacred silence. Thousands standing shoulder to shoulder, packing out Anzac Square here in Brisbane. In that moment of quietness, symbolic of the quietness before the chaos of war would erupt. And here there was around 15,000 people standing shoulder to shoulder. We spoke to a few of them this morning. And those medals, what are they for?
They're from my great-grandfather, I think, and my poppy, he gave me them to wear for today.
We are commemorating our poppy that fought in World War One.
That's one small thing that we can do to commemorate a huge sacrifice.
18 years in the Australian Army, full-time, so it was my early childhood. The service before that was my grandmother. She was a RAC, served in World War Two, and then got history before that. My wife's a direct descendant of an Anzac who was wounded at Gallipoli, so it's deep within our family as well.
As the dawn service has now concluded, many are taking their chance to pay their respects here in Brisbane. The Anzac Day spirit lingering on, guys.
Thank you, Andrea. Lara Vella is at the Cenotaph in Sydney where the service has just concluded. Lara, good morning.
Carl and Sarah, a very good morning to you. You can see the thousands of people who are now starting to disperse as the official ceremony, the dawn service here at the Cenotaph and Martin Place, has just wrapped up. Some of them will be going home, others to various gunfire breakfasts that are being held right across Sydney. It really warms the heart, Sarah and Carl, every year to see more and more people making the pilgrimage here to the Cenotaph, right in the heart of Sydney's CBD, to witness the dawn service. For some people, this will be the first time they have attended one. For other families, though, this has become a wonderful tradition that they attend every single year. Among the thousands of people who have packed out Sydney's Martin Place this morning, of course, with the New South Wales Premier alongside the Governor of New South Wales and the Police Commissioner, and many, many dignitaries from right around the world, including New Zealand. I spoke to some of the early risers who made the pilgrimage to the dawn service this morning. What does it mean to you to be here at the dawn service this morning?
Well, it means that my father and my forefathers and my relatives that died have given me a good life, and I'm very thankful for that. I'm here to honour them.
From 9 o'clock this morning, Sarah, is when the traditional Anzac Day march through the heart of Sydney will commence. This year we are expecting more than 10,000 current and ex-personnel to march through the city alongside more than 40 bands. And the good news this morning, Sarah and Carl, we are expecting clear skies here in Sydney, a beautiful sunny day with a top of 23 degrees. So it should be a wonderful way to honour our diggers today here in Sydney.
That's for sure, Lara. It's the most powerful day, I reckon, on the Australian calendar. On this day every year, we're reminded of the unique and yet shared connection so many Australians have to the Anzac story.
from great-great-grandfathers who fought in the trenches to the mums and dads currently serving today and the organisations making sure our diggers get the support they deserve. Each holds a special place in our hearts today, as Lara Vella reports.
Dawn at Sydney's Bondi Beach. And as the swimmers and the surfers claim their turf on this brisk autumn morning, 86-year-old Noel Bottrell and Alexandra Torrens are here on a mission of mateship through fitness.
And how many have you done now? Is it 23 or 24?
This will be my 24th.
This year, they'll be running with a 300-strong contingent of servicemen and servicewomen alongside New South Wales RSL members to highlight the importance of the organisation's sport and recreation program, an important and, in some cases, life-saving support network for many Australians.
It's a really special day. It was really lovely for me to experience that sense of camaraderie and mateship.
And for 86, he moves pretty quick, doesn't he?
I know. It's a bit of a challenge to keep up, but I do my best.
In 1956, Noel joined the National Service and eventually the Citizens Military Forces. But it was the lack of support for returning Vietnam War veterans that inspired Noel to join the RSL and help make a difference for the next generation.
People who transition out of the Defence Forces into civilian life often are lost and can be placed in a dangerous situation. War is not glorious. It's a terrible thing that young people are sacrificed, really, in politicians' wars. So it's very important that we stand up for our own community.
Alexandra is a reservist in the Australian Air Force, but she's also a proud mum and is sharing her deep respect of Anzac Day now with her daughter.
I think it's really important that we teach the younger generation the importance of Anzac Day and the history. As a mum, we've always made sure that our kids go to those services and recognise that service and that sacrifice and say thank you, because we have a lot to be grateful for.
Imagine first landing at Gallipoli and then just people shooting out on you and you.
At Emmaus College in Western Sydney, these students are on their own mission to learn more about their loved ones who served our country and what Anzac Day means to them.
Who served in the war in your family?
My poppy.
And what do you love best about your poppy?
That he was brave and he did it.
Zach, tell me, what does Anzac Day mean to you?
Anzac Day is a day of remembrance and it remembers who served in the war.
And do you have anyone special in your family that served?
Yes, my great-great-grandfather.
And do you know any stories about him?
That he was lucky enough to survive and earned his medals.
Students Stella Croucher and Cordell Dean both have strong ties to the Anzac story and it's very much inspired them. Cordell has been a Navy cadet for 3 years.
Makes me feel proud. Makes me feel proud that I'm connected to people who have done such selfless things in their life.
And you have your own sort of aspirations, I guess, to join the service.
Yeah, I would really love to be a doctor in the army, like to be able to save people, not just from our country, to be able to help people that are, you know, refugees of their country and trying to escape wars around different areas of the world is like a goal of mine.
To those who serve and to those who may serve one day, each and every one of these Australians has an enduring connection to the Anzac spirit, a legacy that will forever live on.
Wasn't that beautiful?
Oh, it was stunning.
Such a powerful legacy. Such a great day. Such a great shared day across the country, I reckon, with so many connections.
And to see the children really embracing it and carrying on that legacy, it's beautiful.
It's